Hello and welcome everyone to 5G security architecting and mitigation strategy session. This is Taha Sajid. I just want to also thank you for all your comments and feedback regarding my earlier sessions for registration management and session management. And those of you who are watching my video for the first time, so this is actually the continuation of the videos that I'm doing for the 5G topic. So I have already done initial registration for 5G and session management, and this is the third video. So those of you have missed, they can go to my channel and they can have a look on those videos. And I hope that you all are doing great. It's been a while since I have done any video. So now let us see. Okay, so the topic of the security actually is a huge topic, and it covers a wide range of areas. So within the security realm, I try to focus on what we need to address and what are the main focus areas of 5G that we can target. So first of all, we'll be discussing the 5G network security objective. What are the different principles of confidentiality, integrity, availability, and why it matters to 5G. Then we'll be discussing 3GPP guidelines on 5G, what 3GPP has to say in terms of security, that how we can secure our 5G network and what 3GPP guidelines are. Then we'll be going through the 3GPP security architecture. What are the different domains? What is application stratum? What is home stratum? And how you can set up your security architecture, which is very important, because I have noticed that we usually consider security as an afterthought, and once we build this control plane, the user plane, and once we are setting up our 5G architecture, we tends to only address the 3GPP security parameter controls, and we don't see security from a holistic view in terms of its governance model, in terms of what are the different domains, how we need to protect. So before you are doing a 5G SA solution or NSA, try to build a security architecture around it. So then we will discuss sample mitigation scenarios, 5G key assets with threats and challenges, traditional security mapping on 5G network, and also the cloud security mapping, which I will also go through some of the risk measures, and what countermeasures, what are the risk and what countermeasures that we can you can do. Okay, so let us start. If you check the 5G network security, what is our target, what we are trying to protect? So basically, we are protecting the user data and enable network resilience, which means that whatever whatever data our network nodes are processing needs to be secure, and whatever, and with data, what I mean is the keys of the network. We have so many public keys or private keys, or the RSA key that we are going to use. Then we are, in the 5G AKA algorithm, we are driving all the keys, from the authentication vectors all the way towards the safe, and for the confidentiality and integrity protection. So we have to secure all the keys as well as the subscriber data that we will be keeping in our UDR. The subscriber profile needs to be secured because it carries the personal identifiable information, such as the phone number, such as the cell ID, so it is very important for us to protect that information. And then since the telco network is very robust and it has a lot of components, so we need to make sure that we don't have any downtime in our network. So we have to ensure the network resiliency end to end. So basically, and how we can protect it, because if we just go by this protecting user data and network resilience, achieving network resilience, you can get confused that okay, where should we start? So the best approach is to target maintaining confidentiality, which is, for example, if I'm sending A to B, any third person cannot see that data, or there is no middle man in the middle attack that can happen, which is actually the network privacy that we want to achieve. So this can be one of our objectives. Then we should have a data integrity, that whatever A is sending to B, it is the exact copy that the B is receiving from A. This should not be any data tampering that can happen in between. So this is the integrity that we want to protect. Then the availability, that whatever nodes we'll be having, we should have a redundant node, which also tell us that what backups you need to keep it, how you can maintain, if there's a traffic increase, how you can maintain the availability of your network. And then the traceable part, the traceability, which means, for example, if you if anybody is you know accessing some nodes, or there is some escalation of privileges happen, or any you know API request that goes into your network, you should trace it back in terms of who has done and what command he has executed, so you can do some reverse engineering, and you can you know analyze that what's going in inside your network. Okay, so once you can set up your objectives, then you can plan different controls. Okay, now these are the 3GPP security guidelines for 5G from 2019 to 2021, and across those years, and now even in 2022, we are seeing different security measures. So I mean, it's good that 3GPP is having a strong focus now on 3GPP in terms of security, that how we can protect our network architecture. Okay, so there are different measures that they have done. Basically in the release 15, in terms of what are the different things that they have introduced, new authentication framework for 3GPP and non-3GPP access, in terms of they have introduced 5G AKA process, then they have introduced EPA AKA framework with EAP AKA prime, or the dash, you can see it. So which means that it is more stronger, and the authentication vectors are more solid, and you know and it will be very hard to break those things, you know. So the authentication has improved. Then the user plane integrity protection have reduced, which is through their secondary authentication. So for example, once you are setting up your signal registration and control plane, token signaling is done, and once you are doing the PDU session, your user plane is protected by confidentiality, you know, encryption mechanisms. And then we'll go into the detail that how we are doing this thing. Then user privacy protection, that the IMSI that we are sending in the readable format, now it's encrypted, and that's what we are calling as SUPI. So we have introduced this in 5G. Subscriber level security policy, that the UE is now equipped with their own security policy, which is being checked for every PDU session once the request goes to SMF. You know, so if their policy is not right, or is not matching, then he has to, then the PDU session is not verified and stop from SMF. Then it is server based architecture leveraging IPsec and OAuth 2.0, which is the authentication framework, which you can do it from your NRF, that you can you know give the tokens, and that sessions which has been you know happening around the nodes can be protected using OAuth 2.0. and IPsec, of course, that for the user plane security, once the request is going from RAN to EMF in the N3 interface, you can use IPsec always to make sure that the user plane that you are having is encrypted, and you can have a tunnel which is having confidentiality and integrity embedded. Then there is secure interworking between VPLMN and home PLN through SEPP. So for the roaming scenarios, if you're using home breakout, if you're using local breakout or home routing, you are having, you can see there is an SEPP, which is a proxy connected between two networks, home network and the partner network, which is giving you the security. So these are all the measures that the 3GPP has taken. Okay, now moving forward, if we can just look that from the security architecture point of view, that how you can build up your security architecture, this is the question that I was asked, and you know, I've been asked several times in terms of how to build the security architecture. And by the way, you know, 3GPP have, if you read the security architecture, the document 23.501, they have explicitly mentioned everything, you know. So it gives us the details that what is what and how we can set up the domains. But most of the people, or most of I know, don't actually get at what they mean by application strata, which is basically how you are setting up the application. This is the application part, for example, which is the CNF or the VNF part, which is actually been running, the application has been running through them, you know. This is the application stratum. Home stratum is basically where you are storing a subscriber and the authentication key information of your network. This is the home stratum, you know, layer. And serving stratum is how you are handling the routing and the exchanging different elements across the network. This covers in the serving stratum. Then the transport stratum, that how the interconnectivity between all the network is done, how the transport mechanism from the HTTP layer, from the TCP, UDP, the how the backhauling is being done, how your network extending the traffic to the internet. You know, what is the transport layer that is, how the transport layer, for the security standpoint, how you are maintaining it. So these are all the different, you know, stratums that you can divide your network to. And then on top of it, you can then subdivide those stratums into different parts. So for example, network access security is one part. So how your UE is getting access to the network, this is what network access security is. If it's a 3GPP access, for example, a non-3GPP access, how that authentication is being exchanged. So this is the one ground for you. The network domain security, if you see over here, is that, for example, there, if there are different domains, you have, let's say, the control plane, the user plane, how the from the control plane and the user plane, the security is maintained, how they are sending the traffic and how they are interacting with each other. Then the user domain security, for example, if you look at over here, user domain security, which means that from your, what are the measures that you have taken from the UE, on the UE side, what, for example, you're using, you know, KIE or you are using the SUSE and you're using profile A in encrypting the SUPI into SUSE, you know, so what measures you have taken in this regard. Then service, then application domain security, that basically how you are basically in your application stratum, how you are maintaining the security between the user application and the providing application, what goes in the application layer, how you are protecting that information. Service domain architecture, SBA domain security, is basically the SBA, the architecture that you are seeing, AMF, SMF, or you know what the SBA architecture is, how you are maintaining security, whether you're using TLS or, you know, HTTPTS, are you using any PKI to generate the certificates around it, you know. So this is what the service-based architecture domain security is. Then the visibility and configuration of security, that how well you are tracking it, if you have enabled from on the UE side, whether UE can know that whether the handset is protected, is protected or not, you know. So this is all about the security domain. So once you understand this, you know, setup, you can, whatever network architecture elements you are having, whether you're using the 5G SA or you're using interworking with 4G, once you are setting up your architecture, you have to divide then your architecture into different stratums. And for each stratum, you have to then subdivide those stratums into different security domains to tell you basically that what security controls you are putting on what domain, how you are protecting it, what are the different, you know, risk management of that layer, and yeah, how you are controlling it, you know. So basically keeping in mind the confidentiality, integrity, availability and traceability part. So this is what 3GPP security architecture is, and this is how you can build your security architecture. Okay, moving on. So just, this is a sample mitigation scenarios for SUPI encrypted transmission. You know that in the normal 4G case, we are using IMSI, you know, in the plain text format, which is going from UE to eNode B, then to the core network. Although once it has been authenticated, then the network is granting the TIMSI, and then the TIMSI, how it can reach the network from the UE side after using the TIMSI. Similarly, what happens as compared to 5G, they have introduced the mechanism called encrypting the SUPI into SUSE through the profile A encryption mechanism, and this is how the request is being sending to eNode B, and once it is reaching to core network, then the core network is decrypting the SUSE from SUSE into SUPI using the home network private keys basically, and once the authentication has been done, the core network sends back the GUTI, and then the UE from the GUTI, then the UE can be able to reach the network. Okay, the second one, there is the sample mitigation scenario in two, the user plane integrity protection has been done. So if you compare this with a 4G setup, so for example, if there is a valid user, there is a malicious relay over here which is sending a tampering the traffic, and there is a man in the middle attack, which is, for example, bit from the UE and the eNode B. And if there is a relay in between which has come in between, and now it is sending a malicious traffic over here in the core network, how will you identify that, okay, if this malicious relay is redirecting the core network into some malicious DNS, you know? So how you can make sure that even though the authentication is being done properly, then the user plane is protected, or the session that the data is being it's been, you know, authenticated. So they have introduced something called the integrity protection is added to 5G user plane to prevent tampering. So although there is a NAS security layer which has been protected from encryption and integrity, then there is an RRC also. You can see that integrity and encryption is being done on the RRC layer. Once you do the authentication, your UE receive the RRC encryption keys for encryption and integrity. Okay, but they have introduced also the user plane encryption and integrity mechanism, which you know protects the session or the user data through, and this is achieved by the UE security profiles that the user plane took for the user plane that you can set up for your UE in your UDM. And also you can receive once you are done the authentication, you will receive the UP in the for the user plane separate keys for encryption and integrity, and this is how you can protect your session. And of course you can use IPsec from G-Node B to the core network if you want to also protect that N3 layer, you know. So this is how it's been done. And on top of it, whenever the user plane the PDU session is it reached to SMF also checks that in. So this is the added thing also, that to SMF checks that whether the UE has sent any security profile or not. You know, if it's not sent, then if it's have sent something corrupted, then the SMF you know queries the UDM to retrieve the actual security profile of the UP, then the authentication has been granted to the UP to the UE. So this is how the user plane integrity protection has been done in 5G. Okay, what are the key assets of 5G network? 5G networks is comprised of data assets, the equipment assets in terms of dividing into hardware and software. For the data assets, it's basically the user communication data, how the user is communicating with the network, user privacy information in terms of subscription information, location information. Then they have critical reports such as the measurement reports or the CDRs, key data for system operation, and all the logs management data. So this is, you need to maintain the confidentiality and integrity of your data assets. Then in terms of your hardware assets, your all the servers or all your data server, data center equipments, you detect and you can divide, you can classify all those equipments, then you can label it, and then you need to have some sort of mechanism that how you will maintain the availability, confidentiality and integrity of your hardware assets. Then for the software assets, what the software layer are you using in your NFA stack, application, platform and service layer, or the infrastructure layer, which comprise of Docker servers, then there is some cod server that you will be using it, your hardware. So whatever virtualization technique you're using it in terms of images, host, then you're using some pods, or whatsoever you're using, you should have a clear mechanism how you will protect all of this CIA point that we discussed on. Okay, so we will keep the 5G security session up here until here, and in the second video I will go through the remaining of the topics. I hope that you have enjoyed this brief session of 5G security. Hope to see you in the next one. And those of you who have not subscribed my channel yet, I will encourage you to subscribe my channel, and it gives me the motivation to make these videos again, and I hope that you're learning it. And all those who are watching this video, please do leave your comment and feedback that how do you like how do you see this video, and if you like it, please do like it and put your comments. All right, thank you very much all.